O Lord, open our lips, and we shall declare your praise. O Lord, open our lips, and we shall declare your praise.
who's come now before our God with songs, let us hail the Lord. If today you hear God's voice, led by God's hand. If today you hear God's voice, harden not your hearts. Today you would hear God's voice, harden not your hearts, as on the day in the desert, when your parents put me to
as the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so the Son gives life to whom he wills.
As the Father raises the dead and gives them life,
so the Son gives life to whom he wills. Who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. as the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so the Son gives life to whom he wills. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness. As the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so the Son gives life to whom he wills. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. As the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so the Son gives life to whom he wills. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name. As the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so the Son gives life to whom he wills. That in the name of Jesus, every knee should bend of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth. As the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so the Son gives life to whom he wills. And every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. As the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so the Son gives life to whom he wills. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. As the Father raises the dead and gives them life, so the Son gives life to whom he wills.
Sinned. Be A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. But when Christ came as a high priest of the good things that have come, then through the greater and perfect tent, not made with hands, that is, not of this creation, he entered once for all into the holy place, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls, with the sprinkling of the ashes of a heifer, sanctifies those who have been defiled, so that their flesh is purified, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify our conscience from dead works to worship the living God? For this reason, he is the mediator of a new covenant, so that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance, because a death has occurred that redeems them from the transgressions under the first covenant. Where a will is involved, the death of the one who made it must be established, for a will takes effect only at death, since it is not in force as long as the one who made it is alive. Hence, not even the first covenant was inaugurated without blood. For when every commandment had been told to all the people by Moses in accordance with the law, he took the blood of calves and goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop, and sprinkled both the scroll itself and all the people, saying, "This is the blood of the covenant that God has ordained for you." And in the same way, he sprinkled with the blood both the tent and all the vessels used in worship. Indeed, under the law, almost everything is purified with blood. And without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness of sins. Thus, it was necessary for the sketches of the heavenly things to be purified with these rites. But the heavenly things themselves need better sacrifices than these. For Christ did not enter a sanctuary made by human hands, a mere copy of the true one, but he entered into heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God on our behalf. Nor was it to offer himself again and again, as the high priest enters the holy place year after year with blood that is not his own. For then he would have had to suffer again and again since the foundation of the world. But as it is, he has appeared once for all at the end of the age to remove sin by the sacrifice of himself. And just as it is appointed for mortals to die once, and after that the judgment, so Christ, having been offered once to bear the sins of many, will appear a second time, not to deal with sin, but to save those who are eagerly waiting for him. Word of the Lord.
From the Catechesis by St. John Chrysostom, Bishop. If we wish to understand the power of Christ's blood, we should go back to the ancient account of its prefiguration in Egypt. Sacrifice a lamb without blemish, commanded Moses, and sprinkle its blood on your doors. If we were to ask him what he meant, and how the blood of an irrational beast could possibly save men endowed with reason, his answer would be that the saving power lies not in the blood itself, but in the fact that it is a sign of the Lord's blood. In those days, when the destroying angel saw the blood on the doors, he did not dare enter. So how much less will the devil approach now when he sees not figurative blood on the doors, but the true blood on the lips of believers, the doors of the temple of Christ. If you desire further proof of the power of this blood, remember where it came from, how it ran down from the cross, flowing from the Master's side. The Gospel records that when Christ was dead, but still hung on the cross, a soldier came and pierced his side with a lance, and immediately there poured out water and blood. Now the water was a symbol of baptism, and the blood of the Holy Eucharist. The soldier pierced the Lord's side. He breached the wall of the sacred temple, and I have found the treasure and made it my own. So also with the lamb, the Jews sacrificed the victim, and I have been saved by it. There flowed from his side water and blood. Beloved, do not pass over this mystery without thought. It has yet another hidden meaning, which I will explain to you. I said that water and blood symbolized baptism and the Holy Eucharist. From these two sacraments, the Church is born. From baptism, the cleansing water that gives rebirth and renewal through the Holy Spirit, and from the Holy Eucharist. Since the symbols of baptism and the Eucharist flowed from his side, it was from his side that Christ fashioned the Church, as he had fashioned Eve from the side of Adam. Moses gives hint of this when he tells the story of the first man and makes him exclaim, "Bone from my bones and flesh from my flesh." As God took a rib from Adam's side to fashion a woman, so Christ has given us blood and water from his side to fashion the Church. God took the rib when Adam was in a deep sleep, and in the same way, Christ gave us the blood and the water after his own death. Do you understand then how Christ has united his bride to himself and what food he gives us all to eat? By one and the same food, we are both brought into being and nourished. As a woman nourishes her child with her own blood and milk, so does Christ unceasingly nourish with his own blood those to whom he himself has given life.
for our sake. Our Redeemer suffered death and was buried, and rose again. With heartfelt love, let us adore him as we pray.
Christ, our teacher, for our sake, you were obedient even to accepting death. Teach us to obey the Father's will in all things. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Christ, our life, by your death on the cross, you destroyed the power of evil and death. May we die with you, to rise with you in glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Christ, our King, you became an outcast among us, a worm and no man. Teach us the humility by which you saved the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Christ, our salvation, you gave yourself up to death out of love for us. Help us to show your love to one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Christ, our Savior, on the cross, you embraced all time with your outstretched arms. Unite God's scattered children in your kingdom of salvation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray, dear brothers and sisters, to God the Almighty Father, trusting in his love and providence, that he may continue to strengthen and guide us in this time of difficulty and great need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And as we gather our prayers into one this day, those spoken and those held in the silence of our hearts, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. Father, look with love upon your people. The love which our Lord Jesus Christ showed us when he delivered himself to evil humanity and suffered the agony of the cross. He who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let us go in the peace of the Lord. Amen.